Hello there, fellow model makers, and welcome to the sixth and last part of my Kitty Hawk 135th scale Pave Hawk build. Right then, last time we almost completed the main kit. I don't usually add figures to my kits, but I had seen the aftermarket figures online and really thought that they would add to the kit, so I bought them. Let's get cracking. The kit comes with the two pilot figures. I decided to use these instead of the aftermarket ones, as I wanted to see how good or bad they were. They look fairly decent with nice and clear facial features. For the other figures, I bought this aftermarket pack. There are 6 figures in all, but I used only 3, in addition to the 2 from the kit, making a total complement of 5 figures. There are also some additional pieces like ropes and guns in the resin kit, but I did not use these. The figures are made in resin and needed a little sanding here and there to make them fit properly. I used super glue to join the pieces and discovered that there were some gaps between them. But the overall body part and shape seemed to line up nicely, and filling these gaps should not be a problem. To fill the gaps, I will be using Liquitex modeling paste. It works just like any water-based putty and is much cheaper than the branded stuff. Once the putty was dry, I used a Q-tip moistened with water to clean up the extra putty. For the narrower hairline gaps, I used Mr. Surfacer 1000. With the putty now dry, I drill holes in figures so that I can spike them up on cocktail sticks. I now check whether the headpiece fits nicely with the body. If the fit is good, I can paint the head separately, something I prefer to do. Had there been gaps, I would have had to attach the head to the body, fill the gaps with putty and then paint it. But with no gaps, there will be no need for putty, which could ruin the paint job, and I can paint the two parts separately. I now glue in all the accessories, like the sidearm, ammunition magazines and pouches. Thank you. With all the parts glued in place, I give the figures a coat of Tamiya's grey primer. I had to do this outside since the can does throw up a lot of primer. But this is what it looks like before and after the primer. Right, on to painting. The base of the uniform will be this sand yellow by MIG. Then I will use some browns and greens to paint the camo. I start by spraying the base color. The pictures on the net would suggest that the pilots usually wear green flying suits, so I will give them a base of NATO green. The sand yellow base was now dry. I used a brush to paint on the first layer of camo. With the brown done, I now add the green. This is the same NATO green I had used for the pilot's uniform base. For the third camouflage layer, I used a lighter green. The knee guards, gloves, and shoes were painted with wood brown, if I remember correctly. The sidearm, magazines, radio equipment, and such like is painted with black. I try to keep face painting simple in this scale. I start by painting all the accessories, like the headphones and the shades black. a base of skin tone is painted with AK's highlight flesh. This paint is part of the face color set by AK. The final skin color will be painted with light flesh. The beard was painted with ochre yellow, if I remember correctly. This is what the crew looks like after painting is complete and a couple of coats of gloss varnish. The pilots were painted in a similar fashion. Their protective vest was painted with light brown to break up the monotony of the green, and also pictures on the net suggested that brown vest is a fairly common color. To further break up the monotony of the green uniform, I dry brushed the figures with yellow oil paints. Here you can see the before and after difference. When it came to painting the faces, I followed the same steps as for the crew. Just that I added a slight hint of the eyes, since these guys are not wearing any goggles. Once the gloss varnish was dry, I gave the figures a wash with Tamiya's dark brown panel line color. Once the wash was dry, the extra wash was wiped away with a Q-tip moistened with odorless spirit. As you can see, the figures are really shiny, so I sprayed on 3 coats of matte varnish on them before they were glued in place. And that's about it for this build, fellow model makers. I hope you enjoyed this rather lengthy build. If you did, please do leave a like and do subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Also, I look forward to your comments and suggestions. Till next time, good luck and happy model making.